Hi everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another episode of Start to Finish. Boy, I'm excited about this one today. We've got a great episode for you, starring one of my favorite miniatures of all time, Uriah Jacobus. Now, I actually picked this miniature up when I first started painting back in the late 90s, maybe early 2000s or so. And it's basically been sitting partially assembled in a figure case pretty much since then. It's one of those models that I just kind of forgot about, but was so cool at the time. And I was looking through my cases trying to figure out, you know, what to do for this episode. And I saw him and I was like, wow, that's the one. I've never put paint to it. I want to give it a shot. And I love the way it turned out. For me, this miniature, it really stands out for one major purpose, and that's the shotgun. I love the fact that this guy is carrying what in their world would be an old school shotgun. This thing looks like it's something that came right out of the Old West. It's perfect. I mean, it's a beautiful, beautiful looking weapon. But what's so cool about it to me is it kind of reminds me of the movie Aliens, where the character Hicks carries like the old school, just basic sawed-off shotgun as a backup weapon. And, you know, I kind of think about this guy, you know, he looks like this old man with his huge beard, but he's obviously this fierce warrior, and I kind of relate him to Hicks from the Aliens movie. And, you know, he's got the shotgun. He's got a huge, huge chainsword on his back, which you don't see too many people wielding in the 40K universe. I mean, you see a lot of Space Marines wielding, but I rarely see actual humans being armed with chain swords. Mostly it's like power swords and things like that. But obviously the other major piece of this model is the standard that he's carrying. I did some freehand work on the standard. I like the way it turns out. It's not fantastic, but I do enjoy it. And to be honest with you, the key player, the key piece of that whole standard is that brazier on the top. That is an incredible piece of work. It looks beautiful, and it's just absolutely fantastic to look at. It's one of those things where I actually had to get online and look at pictures of burning charcoal to see exactly how to highlight and shade the thing, and it turned out really, really well, I think, anyway. But anyway, just a great model, a lot of fun to paint, and very simplistic in its color schemes. I kind of wanted to let the miniature itself be the impressive part, not the color scheme. And so the very simplistic color scheme, it's basically two colors. It's basically red and white, or sort of an off-white, actually. Sort of a classic color scheme. Red and white's always a good color combination to go with, as long as you sort of... It doesn't work really well if you're going like fire engine red and solid white. You've got to modify one of the colors slightly most of the time, and so I modified the white to sort of an eggshell off-white in two areas, the inside of his robes, and then I went with a more canvas color on the standard. But like I said, great model, fun as heck to paint. I highly recommend picking one up. Just a great, great miniature. Now, that being said, this is a very long episode. I ran all the video through my through Vegas just to see how long it was before we get into this, and it's 8 hours, or just about 8 hours of painting footage. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to speed it up 8 times, which means I'm going to have to render it twice, because Vegas can only speed things up 4 times at once. So I'm going to speed it up 4 times and then twice again. So it's going to go really, really fast, but it should bring things down right into that hour range, which is perfect for this thing. I don't want to start splitting them up again like we did with the Crom the Warlord. You know, we got quite a few views on that first video with Crom, but then they kind of dwindled off on the second. So I'd really like you guys to get it all in one big shot, even if it means a little bit of extra work on my part. But expect to see the entire thing this time. Like I said, it should be about an hour, and I think you guys are going to really enjoy it. Now, If you've never seen an episode of Start to Finish, let me clarify this by saying this is not a tutorial. I've said this many times before. Basically, what this is just you guys getting to watch a piece of art get created. It's one of the most fun videos that I personally enjoy the most. We got a lot of people that love these, and you know, it's one of those things you can just put on, you can put some music on in the background, and you can just watch and see something get created basically from beginning to end. It's very fun, and I think you guys are going to enjoy it. Speaking of music, the suggested music for this particular video. Now, this video was originally supposed to go up in March. Unfortunately, that didn't happen because I had all those internet difficulties. So since we are now in June, here's what we're going to do. I think because we're getting into that summer, we need some summer tunes. And I personally think one of the greatest albums for a summer set of songs is Van Halen's 5150. Highly recommend that you take a listen to that album. Even if you don't do it while you're watching this video, but it might make a great accompaniment to this video. Fantastic album, highly recommend it, and hopefully you'll enjoy that as well. But anyway, that's all I got for you guys for right now. So, sit back and relax and grab some popcorn, grab your favorite non-alcoholic beverage. Again, I recommend a Cherry Coke. And just enjoy watching as we paint Uriah Jacobus from start to finish. That's all I got for you guys right now. Enjoy the video. God bless you all. Have a fantastic rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.